फर्स्ट कंडीशन इज वन वन फंक्शन, वन 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 फंक्शन मीन्स डिस्टिंक्ट एलिमेंट्स ऑफ सेट एक्स मस्ट हैव डिस्टिंक्ट इमेजेस इन सेट वाई, दैट इज इफ एफ ऑफ एक्स वन इज एफ ऑफ एक्स टू टेकन फॉर ऑल एक्स वन एक्स टू बिलोंगिंग टू सेट एक्स एंड इफ दिस अजम्पशन इम्प्लाइज एक्स वन इज इक्वल टू एक्स टू then given function will be called function 1 1. At the same time we can prove the function is 1 1 by assuming x1 is not equal to x2 if two elements of set x has been taken and they are different, then we will show that their images will also be different, that is f of x1 is not equal to f of x2 for all x1 and x2 belonging to set X. So this is a required condition for function to be proved 1 1. Wherever we have to prove function 1 1, then we have to give a thought to one of these two criteria, that is either f of x1 is f of x2 taken, and this if this implies x1 is equal to x2, then function will be 1 1, or this criteria. Unto function. Unto functions are basically those functions. If function is defined from set x to set y, then it says for each y there must exist pre-image in the set x. It means now there should not be any element left in the set y which does not have its pre-image in the set x. So in order to prove the function is unto, what do we do is we write x in terms of y from given fx, which is supposed to be y, and then we analyze, we show it analytically that for all y, this is a symbol for all y belonging to y, there exist, this is a sign of there exist pre-image in the set x. If function is both 1 1 and unto, then collectively we can say function is bijective. That is, these are the two conditions required for function to be bijective. That is 1 1 or unto, and all bijective functions are invertible. And therefore, if function is bijective, then we have already discussed in the previous video that all bijective functions are invertible. So this function, if it has been proved 1 1 and unto, will also be invertible. Invertible means fx is generally taken as y. So if fx is equal to y and function f, this function f is 1 1 and unto, that is bijective, then we can say x is equal to f inverse y. This is the rule. Now let us see some examples that to show that function is a bijective as well as to find the inverse. Such kind of question is also very important, children. Often in board examination, it may come in 2 marks as well as in 4 marks. Depending upon the nature and the length of a solution of a question given. So here I am taking one question, show that function fx is 2x plus 5 upon 3x minus 4, where function is defined from, this is known as set x, this is known as set y, which is r minus 3 by 4 and r minus 2 by 3. To be proved invertible, invertible means bijective, and hence find its inverse. So bijectivity ke liye, as I have already discussed, function has to be 1 1 as well as function has to be unto. So let's see that whether the given function is 1 1 or not. So 1 1 के लिए condition हमने बता रखी है, if assumption of f of x1 is equal to f of x2 implies x1 is equal to x2, then function is 1 1. So here let us assume, let f of x1 is f of x2 for all x1 x2 belonging to set x. And what is set x here? Set x is r minus 3 by 4, and therefore x1 x2 belonging to r minus 3 by 4. This is the assumption, and this must be mentioned here, because x1 and x2 are always taken from the set X in which function is defined. So let f of x1 is equal to f of x2. F of x1 will be obtained from fx, that is 2x1 plus 5 upon 3x1 minus 4, and 2x2 plus 5 upon 3x2 minus 4. Do cross multiplication and get the result as x1 is equal to x2. This means function is 1, 1. When you simplify it, then you will get the relation x1 is equal to x2 as 6x1, 6x2 cancel, minus 20, minus 20 cancel. Combine the remaining terms, you will find x1 is equal to x2. Now the unto function. For unto, I told you that x is written in terms of y. So fx is taken as y, since we know that fx is taken as y and fx was given this. So this means y is taken as 2x plus 5 upon 3x minus 4. Do cross multiplication and find out x in terms of y. X ko y ke terms mein nikal lenge. Now this needs to be analyzed. What was x given? X was given lying between minus r minus 3 by 4 and y was given r minus 2 by 3. So this means if we give a thought to its denominator part, which is 3y minus 2. So if 3y minus 2 is not equal to 0, if 3y minus 2 is not equal to 0 means y is not equal to 2 by 3, which further means if y does not take value 2 by 3, then for all remaining values of y, there must be x which is supposed to be a real number. So this 2 by 3 is already not given in the set y. The set y jo hamara tha, in set y you can see set y is r minus, set y is r minus 2 by 3. So this means 2 by 3 is not there in the set y. This means y cannot take value as 2 by 3. So if y cannot take value 2 by 3, then for all remaining values of